Hello, welcome back. Whenever a company decides to resort to bespoke development for at least some of its management information systems, as opposed to simply purchasing packaged off-the-shelf applications, a software development project starts, and an appropriate development methodology must be chosen. A methodology is a structured way of getting a job done. Management information systems development methodologies specify the sequence of tasks and phases a software development project will follow and the techniques that can be applied at each step. Quite often, companies will fully subcontract this development to specialized consulting companies. Please note that this is absolutely not the same as acquiring an off-the-shelf package. The management information system would still be custom-made according to the user company's specification. In the clothing analogy, it would correspond to having a dress tailor-made by a dressmaker. In this case, the consulting company will normally impose its own proprietary systems development methodology. In fact, it will normally tout the advantages of its methodology as a key selling point. In other cases, however, the user company will either tackle the development with internal resources or use some subcontracted personnel, but nevertheless keep the control of the project. In these cases, it will have to select an appropriate methodology. Most methodologies are based on the understanding that the system being developed will go through a life cycle of gradually more specific and complete phases. At the beginning, it will be just an idea. Along its life cycle, it will become more detailed and be implemented in the chosen programming language. Most methodologies identify similar phases, such as initial analysis, requirements definition, design, development, testing and acceptance, and deployment. Traditional development methodologies follow the so-called sequential or waterfall model. It resembles a tiered or multi-step waterfall in that once the water has fallen to a plunge pool, it does not go back uphill to the previous ones. Similarly, the system being developed should go through each of the phases once and only once. For example, once the requirements definition or functional analysis phase is completed, all the requirements that the management information system must fulfill, all the functionality it must offer, should have been fully specified. The methodology does not allow adding new functionality at a later stage. Large development projects in stable, well-understood environments often follow methodologies based on the waterfall model. It has, however, been criticized as being too rigid and slow. If the needs are not properly understood or if they change, it might lead to systems that do not fulfill the user's needs. To tackle these issues, other methodologies follow an iterative, spiral, or prototyping model. As those names suggest, it involves going through the above-mentioned phases relatively quickly, thus leading to a first rough prototype. This prototype then goes again through the same phases, gradually improving in each cycle, thus advancing in a spiral-like manner. For example, when the prototype is shown to the users, they might find it easier to identify the extra functionality they would like. In recent years, iterative methodologies have evolved into the so-called agile software development. This is an umbrella name encompassing many different development methods, such as Scrum or Extreme Programming, XP. However, they all share common traits that have been summarized in the Agile Manifesto, described in the supporting documentation accompanying these videos. Its 12 principles emphasize rapid prototyping with very short cycles, resulting in continuous delivery of usable software. Daily face-to-face cooperation between business people and developers is encouraged. In stark contrast with the waterfall model, it welcomes changing requirements, even in late development. Agile software development constitutes a reaction, some would think it is an overreaction, to the rigidity and formality of the traditional waterfall model. It can lead to spectacular results under certain circumstances. but it's still hardly applicable for the development of many critical, complex systems with very high quality requirements. Thus, companies embarking in bespoke development must choose and follow an appropriate development methodology. If development is fully subcontracted to a consultancy, it will generally follow its own proprietary methodology. Otherwise, the company must select one. Traditional methodologies based on the waterfall model can be somehow rigid and bureaucratic. Therefore, iterative and lately agile models have been developed. On the other hand, the alternative offered by the open software is growing in importance and acceptance by the corporate users, as we shall discuss in the next video. Thank you. I will see you there.